I welcome you to the first class of our semester. Today we are going to start our first topic. We are studying applied chemistry. Okay. Now the first topic is water. You know very well about water, its molecular weight, its formula, its hybridized state, everything we have studied in 11th and 12th class. Actually, what we have to study here is about the applications of water. You know very well, water is a very important part of our life. We could not expect our life without water. At domestic level, at industrial level, water is very useful. We could not imagine any industry without water. We could not imagine our life, our domestic need without water. Okay, so water is needed everywhere. But one thing you know very well, that there are specific things required in water. Means special characteristics should be present in water for a particular use. Suppose we are drinking water. Now one thing there should be in your mind, that if I am drinking water, then there should be no microorganisms present in water, no TDS. The TDS of water should not be very high. Okay, so this is the required thing if you are drinking water. If the same water is used in industry, then there will be no problem of microorganism. What is the thing? The main thing, that the water should not be having any hardness in it. Okay, so hardness should be removed if we are using water at industry. Especially if we are talking about boilers, that we are going to study further in this chapter. Okay, so we are studying, mainly we are concentrating here about the hardness of water. So we should know what is actually hardness. If we are talking in a common language about layman's definition, then what is hardness? Hardness in water is the characteristic that prevents lathering of soap. Okay. If water is not giving lather with soap, continuously rubbing the soap against water, and if it is not giving any lather, then you will say that the water is hard. And if it is giving a good lather with soap, then we will say that the water is soft water. Okay, so what is hardness? Hardness is the characteristic that prevents lathering of soap. Okay, now why this hardness? Why this hardness is present in water and how? Okay, so why this hardness is present? It is due to the presence of dissolved salts in water. Some of the salts are present and that are dissolved in water, and that are the cause of hardness in water. Okay, if you take a glass of water, okay, just by looking at it, you could not say that the hardness is present in water or not. Okay, because these salts are present in soluble form in water. Okay, so the dissolved salts in water are the main cause of hardness in water. Okay, now the soap is not giving lather. So this we can explain with the help of this equation. What is soap? Soap is the sodium salt of fatty acid. We have taken sodium stearate, that is C17H35COONA. When this soap is treated with water, water is having, see, this hardness. Okay, this hardness is of calcium chloride, means dissolved salt in water. Due to the CaCl2, the soap do not form lather, but it forms an precipitate. Okay, it forms a precipitate and insoluble scum, white colored scum, and that is not lather. Okay, so due to this, reaction explains why the water is not giving lather with soap. Now we'll talk about hardness. We have classified the hardness in two types: temporary hardness and permanent hardness. Now what is temporary hardness? Okay, the name indicates that this hardness is not temporary. Okay, it is also known as carbonate hardness, and it is due to the presence of salts of calcium bicarbonate, magnesium bicarbonate and iron carbonate. Okay, these are the salts responsible for temporary hardness. Now, if we come to the permanent hardness, also known as non-carbonate hardness, and the salts that are responsible for permanent hardness are कैल्शियम एंड मैग्नीशियम सॉल्ट. ओके, कैल्शियम क्लोराइड, मैग्नीशियम क्लोराइड, कैल्शियम सल्फेट, मैग्नीशियम सल्फेट, सल्फेट्स ऑफ आयरन, सल्फेट्स ऑफ एल्युमिनियम, सल्फेट्स ऑफ क्लोराइड, एल्युमिनियम क्लोराइड. ओके, दीज आर द सॉल्ट्स दैट आर रिस्पॉन्सिबल फॉर परमानेंट हार्डनेस इन वॉटर. नाउ द नेम इंडिकेट्स टेम्पररी हार्डनेस इज नॉट टेम्पररी, इज टेम्पररी सॉरी, एंड परमानेंट हार्डनेस इज परमानेंट. इट मीन्स दैट इफ विल बॉइल वॉटर, ओके, देन द टेम्पररी हार्डनेस कैन बी रिमूव. ओके, टेम्पररी हार्डनेस कैन बी सिंपली रिमूव्ड बाय बॉइलिंग द वॉटर. यू मस्ट हैव बॉइल्ड वॉटर. ओके, आफ्टर बॉइलिंग यू हैव सीन दैट व्हाइट कलर प्रेसिपिटेट्स सेटल्स डाउन इन द यूटेंसिल इन विच यू आर बॉइलिंग वॉटर. ओके, सो वॉट दैट व्हाइट प्रेसिपिटेट, इट इज द टेम्पररी हार्डनेस दैट वॉज प्रेजेंट इन वॉटर. ओके, सो दैट इज वाई वी से दैट टेम्पररी हार्डनेस इज टेम्पररी, मीन्स इट कैन बी रिमूव्ड बाय बॉइलिंग द वॉटर. Now, how it can be removed? See this. I have written calcium bicarbonate. Calcium bicarbonate means it is the temporary hardness present in water. Same way, magnesium bicarbonate, it is also temporary hardness. Now, if we heat this water having calcium and magnesium bicarbonate, then what happens? It converts in the form of white precipitate, as I already told you. This white precipitate is of calcium carbonate, and in this case, it is of magnesium hydroxide. Okay, so this white precipitate settles down, and in this way, the temporary hardness is removed by boiling the water. But this permanent hardness is permanent. Okay, if we boil water, then this permanent hardness could not be removed. There are specific methods like lime soda method, zeolite method, reverse osmosis method, ion exchange methods that we are going to study in our further classes. Okay, so these are the methods. By these methods, by opting these methods, we can remove the permanent hardness in water. Okay, so this was the type of hardness that is present in water. Now in our next class, we will be studying about what problems this hardness caused in domestic level as well as in the industrial level. Okay, so with this we have come to end, to give an end to our today's class. In today's class we have studied about hardness. Okay, so have a nice day and stay nice at your place. Good day.